Hello everyone, my name is Nighthawk. Welcome to American Truck Simulator. I've been thinking about doing this for a while, but I made the decision to record this today, as I thought this would be a great addition to my channel as a series. So we're gonna be doing a special transport today of what I believe is a haul truck chassis. So this is gonna be from Phoenix, Arizona, all the way to Sierra Vista. So we are operating Nighthawk Logistics based out of Arizona. It used to be based out of Los Angeles, but we've moved to Phoenix for business reasons. So now we're out here at our garage. We're actually going to, we don't need to fill up. I believe they do it for us. So let me just get my seat in proper position here. We are driving the Freightliner Cascadia today, and it's got my custom paint on it. And some of our trailers also have custom paint on them as well. So I didn't really put any effort to the logo. Just some basic design. Nothing else. Black on white. So we're gonna change this heads-up display information here. And now let's get on out of here. I do have to note that I am using a controller to play this game. I don't have a wheel. I don't have any pedals. I just have a Xbox controller, but it does mostly fine for the job. Like, I can steer perfectly and with reasonable precision, but I do understand that yes, with a wheel you get even more precision, so it's a lot better. But the controller has been fantastic. Like, there's no issues using it at all. So I guess we can cross the road here, please. Oh my god, you stupid bitch. So our truck, looks like the truck's condition is still in good order here. We are not getting a good frame rate down here in the city. So we're gonna make our way to the pickup area and get ourselves sorted out. We'll just make sure no one's crossing the... Are you gonna go? Alright, okay, thank you. I do have... thank you, GPS. I do have a bunch of mods in this game, such as traffic, some seasonal graphics, and of course we're on 1.40, so the game looks fantastic. And there's just a long list of mods here that I cannot name all of them, but we'll go along what I have as we go through this playthrough here. So how far is this place? Oh my god, it's all the way down there, the southeastern portion of Phoenix. Oh, we're exceeding the limit, sorry. Hope you guys are having a beautiful weekend. It is a Saturday for me here. As I've said in my previous videos, I have just started flight school, and I have actually just completed my solo just a few days ago, and it was amazing. The feeling of completing your solo is just fantastic, and it just makes you feel like you're on your way to the next milestone. So, but we're still continuing with our flight training here. So I will still be busy on the weekdays as usual. Alright, we're getting onto the highway here. I just make sure that I'm not gonna hit somebody. Getting on the 17 southbound. Oh lord. Oh, there's traffic right behind us. Alright.
Keep to the right and then turn right.
And just as soon as we get on, we get off.
Turn right.
Now our frame rate's looking good.
Use the left lane ahead.
Still choppy in some places, but nonetheless better. I do have the spring mod by Grimes installed as well. Of course, we're in Phoenix. It doesn't look like it's spring at all. Looks like it's... just looks like a hot fucking desert as usual. So we're gonna be making our way over there. How far are we? We are 27 minutes away in game time. And we are about 50 miles out. So once we do get this cargo, we'll get ourselves squared away. Oh my god, I almost missed my... I almost got off there. Wasn't in the correct lane. God, I had my engine brake turned on. Or turned off, rather. So what I like about Special Transport DLC is it just makes the game a lot more challenging, especially when you're maneuvering cargo through tiny roads. Although in the US or in American Truck Sim, American Truck Sim in general, the roads are a lot larger, so you do have a lot of room. But of course, the trailer you're carrying to, or the trailer you're using to carry this cargo, is a lot larger. So it is quite the, oh my god, brakes! Brakes! Jesus Christ, this thing has no brakes. Let's turn the motorcycle into a pancake. Please let me through, thank you. Man, we are losing frames. Turn off the engine brake here since we're in the urban area. We're on surface streets now. Yeah, our frame rate is taking a nosedive in here. But hopefully once we get on the highway and get this delivery started, we will be good to go if this light would just turn green. It actually looks like the airport. Not sure what airport this is. I'm guessing this is Sky Harbor Airport. I can't really be sure. We are in the... No, not really the... I think we're in the southwest or southeast area of Phoenix. I believe the airport's somewhere there. Man, I don't know. I've never been to Phoenix in my life, but... I've only seen it in Flight Sim. Alright, I guess after the left turn, we're gonna make another right turn up here.
Keep to the right, and then turn right.
By the way, I'm also driving on an automatic because, again, I'm on a controller. I don't feel like it's worth driving a manual if I don't even have the ability to control the clutch one way or the other. So, yeah, we're on an automatic in a Freightliner. Fairly modern truck, so I guess most likely it'd be automatic. Looks like the weather is starting to get bad. It's already cloudy up there. But we are almost here to pick up our haul truck chassis. Make sure no one's crossing the street here. Make another right turn here.
Turn right.
Alright, we're here.
Your destination.
Yeah, no shit. Alright, we're here. Let's get the trailer sorted out. Yep, that's the one we want. And our truck is, or rather, has always been ready to go for heavy cargo. We got the, I think we got the 6x4 chassis. And we have probably the most powerful engine you can get in this game, at least for this truck. Okay, let's go.
Please proceed to the
truck. Tanks were refilled and ours restored. Here you have it. Look at this thing, it is long, and it's nighttime too. Holy shit, this is gonna be interesting. Hopefully that means there won't be a lot of traffic on the road out tonight. Yeah, look at this thing. I did not check how heavy this thing was, but we'll check here in a minute. So let me just review the rules here, because it has been a while since I've done one of these things, so... Of course, follow the route. Don't stop to rest or use the gas stations. Do not drive out the estimated route. And this is how you change lanes, so... Rear escort car goes first, and then... You, or the forward, and then the forward escort car changes lane, and then you proceed to change your lane as well. All right.
Navigation resumed.
Okay. Let's just take a good look around the area for a bit. So we got the media here, Fox News covering this transport for some reason. Then you got the haul truck chassis at the back with the oversized load banner flying at the back and the red flags. How heavy is this thing? 187,392 pounds. Holy Jesus. Alright, we're gonna turn on our beacon lights here. We'll turn on our headlights as well. And let's get the show on the road. We don't have a lot of time as well. So there's the escort vehicle. That's going to follow behind us. And ahead of us is going to be a Arizona DPS trooper, if I'm not mistaken. Oh my god. Look at that. Truck's already having trouble accelerating out of here. So what I like to do is I open the windows. Or at least open the window on my side so I can at least see what's behind me. Got a lot of people helping us transport this beast today. So we are headed to Sierra Vista, Arizona. With this 187,000 pound haul truck chassis. Got a lot of law enforcement out here today helping us out with this. Alright, let's slow down here. Make sure we're not clipping the gate here.
Turn left.
Oh, this is the challenging part here. Trying to turn on this narrow road. Got a trooper blocking off the road for us. Thank you. Or no, that's Phoenix Police, actually, not a trooper. Alright, let's just make this turn as wide as possible. But not too wide. We're gonna close the window once we get on the highway and we don't have to make any turns for the next couple miles or so. Hopefully no one is coming on this lane as well. Because if there is a motherfucker coming on this lane, oh man, it's gonna be a bad day for me. Alright, so it looks like we're gonna make a left and a right and then a left onto the highway. I believe that's the highway. Yep, we're getting onto the 10 southbound. Are we looking here over to the right? It's not very bright, so I can't really see my cargo, but
in 650 feet, turn left.
It's 9 p.m., so I think we're good here. We shouldn't encounter a lot of traffic.
Turn left.
There's more Arizona DPS helping me out with the traffic here. Thank you for the help, boys. Alright, let's make this turn as carefully as possible. Make sure we don't clip at the traffic. But not too wide that we clip the other side as well. Man, I don't have track IR as well, so I'm gonna have to use my controller to look around. And there's no way to adjust the sensitivity of how you look around as far as I'm concerned, so that's another issue I've had. Alright, I'm gonna get over to the far left side here and make a right turn. You want to make the turn as wide as possible to give yourself some room, especially for the trailer, the long trailer behind us that wants to swing around everywhere. All right, I think we're good there on that end. I know I should be on the right side generally, but as far as I know from what I've learned from this kind of
50 feet, turn left.
These kinds of special transport jobs take as much space as you need. You just need to take up the amount, just as much space as you need to get this trailer where it needs to go if you need to. Use the opposite lane if you have to. Here's another unit there blocking off traffic. There's Phoenix PD. Just a few more and we will be on the 10 southbound. Alright, we're approaching the intersection near Highway 10.
Keep to the left and then continue straight.
Alright, left turn out here. Oh my god, we got cars coming in now. Oh, we're not turning here yet. My bad. God damn it. Oh lord. We got traffic here. Oh man. Looks like we're stopped behind this truck of mine, which is from my own company. If he could get moving, that'd be great. Oh god, there's people honking behind me. Shut up! I'm special! Alright, we're just waiting for this Nighthawk logistics truck, ironically enough for my own company, to move its ass, but it's waiting for a green light. Dude, you got a trooper behind you. Move your ass. Oh, Christ almighty. This is gonna take a while. We're literally stuck. I do have a traffic add-on. Traffic density add-on, and it does cause issues sometimes, so... That's another... thing I have to deal with. Oh, Christ. We've been sitting here for a few minutes, and the truck hasn't moved yet. We're gonna have to reload the game, so I'll be right back, boys. Alright guys, we've reloaded the game, all the traffic is gone, and we should be able to... Shut up, GPS. We should be able to continue on our way. Alright, left turn, it is out of here. You better not fucking cross. Thank you, trooper. Alright, make this left turn again as wide as possible. Escort truck making sure I don't hit anything. Looks like we're gonna be clear off that traffic light. Oh my god, we have 187,000 pounds on this thing. I am pedal to the metal right now, and this thing is struggling to climb up this hill. There's another trooper stopping traffic on the highway. I appreciate it. You're almost there. Alright, I believe we are... How long are we... Okay, we're gonna be on the Route 10 for a while. Going southbound, so I guess we can close the window now since we don't have to make any more... crazy maneuvers here. And it looks like we are on our way to Sierra Vista. Yeah, this thing is struggling to accelerate it to 40 miles per hour. Should also keep in mind of the traffic passing us on the left. Make sure we don't cross over to the left as much. I'm gonna utilize the room we have on the right side, the emergency lane, so that I don't take up any space on the left and traffic can pass perfectly fine. Oh, we're about to change lane here. Yep. No problem. No problem at all. I'm gonna turn on cruise control and turn on the engine brake as well, just in case we need to stop on a dime. I am using the municipal police traffic pack. I forgot who's the author of it, but it is on the Steam Workshop. It's the only one, and it is a very high quality mod. I do recommend it. It adds real life police departments and gets rid of the ugly looking lore police models and liveries that you see in the game. So yeah, they do add actual models and including municipal police departments as well, which is pretty cool. Oh god, we got a fucker passing us on the left. Gotta make sure we don't hit him, or else he's gonna sue us. So another thing you have to do while on the highway is to check periodically behind you, because sometimes the escort vehicle likes to stop and take a break without your permission, and then you fail the transport mission because you've abandoned the transport vehicle without you knowing, because you know you weren't able to look behind you. So I do like to check behind me once in a while to see if the escort vehicle is still following behind, which is a good thing because we got a lot of traffic. I mean, we have a lot of traffic following behind us. Oh god. We're drifting off our lane here. A lot of troopers out on the road today. Make sure traffic's flowing along smoothly and I don't get hit by something, or I hit something. I'm sorry, what did the GPS say? Use the left lane ahead or use the right lane ahead? Oh shit. Oh man, here comes a curve. Let's negotiate it very carefully here. I believe that trooper head is blocking traffic. Thank you, good sir. Oh, change lane, he said. Alright. We managed that pretty good. So we are about 130 miles from our destination, which is Sierra Vista. We got 2 hours and 45 minutes to go in-game till we get there. And it's dead of the night, so not a lot of traffic, which is good for us. You can pretty much move where we need to if we need to, and don't have to worry about traffic, although there is quite a bit of traffic behind us, so there's that to deal with. Alright, since this is going to be a long drive, I'm going to time-lapse a good portion of this, and I'll see you once we get near to where we are. Why are we slowing down? Thought you were gonna change lane, buddy. Dude, change lane. Come on. Man, we're actually slowing down here because this guy's not gonna change lane. Come on. Are you gonna change lane or what?
Use the left lane ahead.
Yeah, I know I'm supposed to use the left lane ahead, but this guy doesn't want to use the left lane ahead. Oh, shit. We're rolling forward. Parking brake on. Oh, man. Are we stuck again? I swear to fucking God. You gonna move over to the left or what? Man, I don't want to have to fucking reload my game. You still good back there? Yeah, he's stuck. What if I turn off the indicator? Will this truck go through? Alright, turning off the indicator makes this truck beside me go through. Let's see if the trooper's gonna move over. I am a fucking genius. I am a fucking genius. Holy shit, we don't have to reload the game. Man, the traffic density mod, or any traffic density mod for that matter, can sometimes screw up the game. Let me just close the window here. Yeah, they can screw up special transport DLCs pretty bad. Let's just make sure the escort car is still behind me. Make sure we don't hit that other escort car. So yeah, looks like we mitigated that issue. Still got a long way to go. We're about to pass by the Tucson here. So I'll see you on something else. Once we negotiate something else here on this highway. Like we're about to get on the 90 here and exit off here, exit off Route 10, and we'll be continuing on still south towards our destination. Hopefully this won't be a difficult maneuver. Let's see what the maneuver ahead looks like. Looks like it's just a simple exit and then a right turn. So we'll see about that.
Keep to the right, and then take the exit on the right.
Taking the exit on the right.
Use the right exit ahead.
Use that engine brake. Slow down here. Yeah, slow down here. We're on a downhill. Since we're heavier, we got a lot of inertia going on, so we need to use that brake. We need to use the brakes as much as we can. Right, right turn down here. And another wide right turn. Wait for me, trooper. It's gonna take me a while to get there.
Continue straight.
What the hell is that? A fucking dinosaur here. If anyone from Arizona or from Tucson specifically knows what that is, please comment down below, because I don't know what that is. Looks interesting. Got a trooper stopping traffic as usual. And we are on the 90. Looks like it's another long stretch of road. Actually, I think we're almost there at Sierra Vista. Just make sure I'm not going to hit the guardrail here, because we're about to hit the guardrail. So we are about 26 miles away, just half an hour away. So hopefully I'll see you once we get there. Alright, here we are, Sierra Vista. Gotta slow down here since we're within city limits. Gotta turn off the engine brake as well, because we got people who don't like that sound. Just gonna go through this intersection here without any issues whatsoever. Make sure we don't hit anything. Man, even at this speed, it feels like we're speeding through the road here. And could potentially hit something with our cargo, which is protruding off to our sides here, both the left and the right. Just wait for this car to get through the intersection, then we can be on our merry way. Looks like the drop-off point is just up ahead. Should it be far now? Make sure we don't hit that cop car over there. Again, using any space available as desired to safely get this cargo to its destination and maneuver around any difficult areas. 35 miles down here. We're gonna go even slower than that. Got traffic behind us. Make sure they're not passing us on the left, because I really fucking hate that. But, looks like we are here, BHP. Welcome to this BHP facility! Oh my god, I thought he was just gonna stop right in front of us. That scared the shit out of me. Alright, looks like we're here. Trooper, I appreciate the escort. Thank you for the help. And parking this says pretty simple. Just gotta park it in the spot. No need to reverse and do any of that crap, because this is technically a tandem or articulated trailer, so that might be a problem if you try to reverse it, so just gotta drop it off right here. Easy peasy. Just stop right there. Alright, we're here. Let's drop off the cargo. And of course we get an excellent, pretty easy, $19,000, but it was $100 per mile, which was pretty much worth it for that short trip. So yeah, that's gonna do it for this episode of American Truck Sim. Hopefully it wasn't that short, just wanted to do an American Truck Sim video. But yeah, if you'd like to see more content, hit the subscribe button. And if you like this video, hit the like button. That's gonna do it for this episode of American Truck Simulator. My name is Nighthawk, and I will see you guys in the next video. Peace out.